Hello, hope everyone's having a good day. I just wanted to make a couple quick corrections to a technical analysis I did on Alexander Tammert. One, I would like to say in the beginning of that video, I accidentally said that he got last in this competition when I was getting that confused with him in 2008, in the 2008 Olympics in Beijing, where he got last, but he was out of his prime and nobody really expected him to win. I mean, he was pretty old at that point. Or medal. He got bronze on this particular throw in 2004. Okay? I just want to make that perfectly clear. I correct it in the video description, but just in case people don't look at that, I also list all the medals, his accomplishments, and his height and weight, if I can find, like, when I found it. I also went back through all my videos and did that for everybody. The height and weight, sometimes I couldn't find it, so if it's missing, that's why I couldn't find it, or I couldn't find a reliable source to state that. Also, I wanted to say that I in no means think that this is a bad throw, because obviously it got him bronze in the Olympics. I state over and over again how much I love this throw. In all the videos in this series, I just point out things that I think are wrong. Or not even wrong, just different or unique. Or what people should look out for if people use these throwers as technical models. That the things these throwers do may not work for for other people. And this is what makes them throw far, not you. You have to find your own technique and style. Okay? I also wanted to comment that I know very little about the coaches who coach these people. One, because it's hard to find a lot of the coaches. Find, like, who coached a lot of these people, because sometimes I do a lot of old throwers and or just throwers from different countries, and I can't understand their language or their writing. So I in no mean way I sorry I in no way want to offend any coaches or anything. I just assume that he was coached by Vastenis Tysin. Because at the time he was the Estonian national coach, and Alexander Tammert competed for Estonia. And I just assumed because him and Gerd Kanter were teammates during this Olympics that Vastine would have been coaching both of them. So, my apologies. I also want to comment that his left arm, I in no mean, I don't know why I said it was too loose. I personally don't know why that means, even though I said it. Well, I mean, it's just you don't see very many people wind like this. So that's all I meant, was that it's pretty unique, and that maybe it's something that a lot of people should not really try and copy. Because once again, this worked for him. But this won't work for a lot of people. Just like Adam Nelson was a great thrower. Great, great thrower. One of the best shot putters of all time. But, and by no means should really a lot, the majority of throwers ever try and, like, copy his technique. Because that was his technique. He could throw like that. Not, that's why you don't see a lot of people with his kind of left leg in the front. Because, you know, a lot of people can't do that. And he just did that naturally. Okay? So, I was just simply pointing out, and that's also another thing. When I choose a thrower, it's not simply their accomplishments. It's also if they do something unique or something that I feel deserves, like, mention. I also wish I didn't ramble a lot in these videos, I usually do these late at night because I'm busy during the day and I'm pretty tired. And I'm just a big nerd for throwing and I just get carried away. So if you have any questions by what I mean in a video, or if something just doesn't make sense, just ask me and I'll respond, because yeah, I'll just respond, you know? So, and I'll try and clarify what I mean. I also by no means say that I know everything about throwing. Okay, I literally just got out of college. Okay, I'm trying to throw post-collegiate. All I want to do is just spread love for this sport, because this sport has brought me nothing but happiness and joy. Okay, so, and I hope it will do the same for a lot of other people. I also want to point out that it's just this left arm in particular. I'm just stating that this left arm at the start of his wind is unique. But he immediately, like, well, not immediately, but he eventually, when he gets here, when it's actually important, it's long. And I am by no means think that this position right here is bad at all. I actually love this position. This actually reminds me of Virgilius Alekna a lot. So, I mean, and to me, he's the best discus thrower of all time. So, his left foot does not turn all the way. But he can get away with this because he's set up offset. So, he's not lined up here and here with, here and here with his legs. He's lined up here and here. So, he doesn't have to turn his foot all the way. Because if you notice, he's still going. His foot is pointed to the front. So he's still sprinting forward. And he still lands pretty in the middle. I mean, nobody's perfect. I mean, he could be a little more over here, but I mean, doesn't matter, honestly. I mean, he got bronze in the Olympics. He can do whatever he wants. And he's a 70-meter thrower. I mean, it's all good. Another thing, I do like this hip position. Okay. I mean, sorry, this foot position. I mean, his foot, I would like it to be like a little bit more over here. But this isn't bad by any means. I love this separation he gets with the back. I love the separation that he has with his hip to the discus. I know you can't really see the discus because it's all blurry. But discus is like right here. His hip is right here. He gets so much separation. And one of the reasons I really like this video, and well, this throw in particular, and Alexander Tammer, is because of his block. I believe that he has one of the best blocks ever. It's very nice. All I'm stating is I feel like he just released it a little too early. Because it's flying over here when it should be flying more over here. So he could have got more out of it. That was because he just landed like a little bit blocked off. But when you're at this level, like a tiny thing can result in a big thing. If that makes sense. Probably doesn't, but yeah, I more just want to make some corrections. I might want to do this for some of my other earlier videos, because I may have said some things that aren't true. And I hope that this clears up some stuff that I might have said in the other video. So, yep, hope everyone has a good day.